name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how we can maintain our single crystal that has been growing. For the experiment, I'm going to use my single crystals that have been growing in my saturated alum solution for about a week. And you can see how the alum crystal has grown so large that now the thread is completely incorporated inside the crystal. You'll also notice that there may be some small crystals growing on the bottom, and there may be some small crystals growing on your thread. Now, all of those crystals that are in your solution are competing for growth. The more you have in there, the more difficult it will for your large crystals to grow even bigger. So in order to help them out, there are a couple things that we need to do. First, we're going to use some deionized water, because every time we remove the solution, we need to rinse the excess solution around them and any dust or particles that they may pick up in the process. Next, we're going to need another beaker in which we're going to decant our saturated alum solution, because we need to remove all the little crystals that are involved. We'll also need a watch glass. And we're going to use this to place our crystals on. You may also use a paper towel for that purpose, because the crystals you can dry, and then if you rinse off any dust or other particles that you pick up in the process, that is still okay. And then finally, to remove the small crystals that appear along the thread, you may want something that allows you to crush them, and I typically use a spatula or a scoopula. To decant the solution from the top of the small crystals, we're going to also need a stirring rod, and that one will be used to complete a decanting process. So I have that here. The first step is to extract the crystals. I will lift them up and transfer them carefully onto my watch glass. I will try to hold the pencil in place as much as possible. Then I will decant my solution. For decanting, you want to place a stirring rod across the top of your beaker, just like this. And then as you lift it up and hold it in place, your solution will follow the path of your stirring rod and transfer to where you want to send it. This way you can see whether or not your small crystals are moving. If they are moving, then the stirring rod can slow down their progress. But mine didn't move that much, and they are still on the bottom of my original beaker. With the decanting completed, all my solution is clear, and now whatever I place in it is the only thing that will grow. Next, we follow up with our crystals. They are relatively large, but there are some small crystals that are growing along the thread. So I will take my scoopula and press against those crystals with the watch glass at the bottom. This will allow me to crush the crystal and then gently scrape them away. If there is some resistance, we just need to press a little harder. But when we do the scraping, you need to be very careful not to accidentally break the thread, because then you have to begin again with the tying of the crystals. And with that, all the excess crystals have been removed, both from the solution and the thread. And now if we place these two crystals inside our growth solution, these will be the only two that will grow. So I will pick up my cardboard top with my pencil. I will first submerge it inside some deionized water. It doesn't matter how much water you're using or what kind of beaker you're containing it in. The important thing is that you need to have enough water so when you dunk your crystals in it, they are fully submerged. And then it is a good idea to keep it there for at least 30 seconds to a minute. At this point, you're not worried about the crystals falling off because the thread has been completely integrated inside the crystal. And when you're done with the rinsing of your crystals, then very quickly, you will move your crystals into the growth solution again. If you need to, you can adjust the height of your crystals, making sure that they're approximately in the middle of your growth solution and not touching the sides of the beaker or the bottom of the beaker. And for sure, they're not exposed to the air, because then whichever part is connected to something else or exposed to air, that is the part that will not grow.